All right, so this is gonna be a good one. This is the FPV drone that I usually fly. Fun to fly, but the image quality, nah. Now this is a cinema camera that I shoot on. Awesome image, but it doesn't fly. Or does it?
Well, it could if you get yourself a pro drone pilot, give him a flying lawnmower, and put your $8,000 cinema rig on top of it.
So I always wondered what it takes to actually get cinema-grade FPV footage. So let's figure this out by shooting a spec commercial for today's sponsor, 10 Ways. They do electric bikes, and it happens to match my snowboard jacket because it's freaking winter in Chicago. Okay, let's actually record some talk about the gear.
So these FPV drones, compared to other drones, they just allow you to fly way faster, way closer to things, through tiny gaps if you have a smaller one, and just inject a lot of energy and action to your shot and give you a different kind of view that you're not used to from standard drones that just like hover in the air. These drones usually fly with a GoPro on there because, you know, you occasionally crash them, and so having a robust camera on there is very helpful. And if you think about the cinema world, the Komodo is basically the GoPro of the cinema camera, super robust. That's actually why many FPV pilots actually use Komodos to strap them on these bigger rigs. So let's talk with Nikolai about this actual rig.
Well, first of all, my first question is, how much is the whole setup of the drone without the Komodo?
If you were to build it yourself, it was around $2,000-ish to build it with about one battery. If you don't trust yourself to build it, as it is a $5,000, $6,000 camera on there, and you want to buy one from a company, they can range from anywhere from $2,000 to $15,000.
So we just encountered a little bit of an issue. The Komodo is shutting down with a shake. So that's a problem. Hopefully we can recover these clips in post, but every time we land we get that shake. Even that tape here not working.
But like how long does it stay in the F4 on average?
Yeah, so on these ones I have around 4500 milliamp hour batteries, which are a little on the small side, so these get around like 5 minutes of flight time ish of like aggressive flight time. If you're really flying aggressive, probably only like 2 or 3 minutes, but you can put bigger batteries on there. But then again, it is heavier, it's a little less agile, but you would trade off and get a little more flight time.
Gotcha.
My 5-inch one, depending on the battery, I can get like anywhere from like 6 to 10 minutes on that thing.
So generally what we recommend doing, or what many people are doing as well, is like they use these 5-inch to basically pre-concept the shot. Mm. Do a dry run with it, see if everything works out, and then get these big boys up here, right?
Especially when you're flying in an area you haven't flown before, like the cameras are pretty low quality, you see in the goggles, so trees and little sticks and all that stuff are pretty hard to see, and the last thing you need is to test it out and clip a tree with this. It's a lot easier to replace a little 5-inch than this thing, obviously.
Yeah, if that goes down, there's a lot of damage here, and also you don't want to hit your talon with it. I'm gonna tell you, it's like it's scary when this thing zips around you.
Scary. I mean, it's freaking scary if it just zooms around you and you're on your bike and you just have to rely on your drone pilot not to hit you with a freaking lawnmower.
Also, let's talk about lenses, because as with a GoPro, you always shoot wide angle lenses, and in the FPV world, generally speaking, you shooting wide angle. So what do we have on here right
so
now?
So on this, we have a 10 millimeter Laowa F4 like pancake lens. And it's definitely not the highest quality of lens, but I think it's only around 150 to 250 grams. So you definitely save a ton of weight, and it's super low profile. So it's really easy to fly on pretty much anything.
So yeah, low weight and wide angle, super important. So what we're also gonna try out is the 16 millimeter GDU lens. So these are rehoused Canon lenses. This is for the RF mount as well. And they're only autofocus, but they are basically like a tank. I mean, I could throw this possibly just like over there, and then, you know, I'm not gonna do that.
We're also giving the whole rig now a little tail here with the GoPro Hero 10 Bones, just for you guys, so that you can see what life as an FPV drone is like. All right, Nikolai, what's that thing up top there?
So that is a thing called a Stead XP, and it basically gets gyro data
while I'm flying, so then after the fact I can put it into its software and then stabilize all the footage if you don't want it to be shaky.
Very important, because these things have inherent vibration. That's why actually the Komodo is really good for it too, because it has the global shutter, so you don't have any jello effect through any micro vibrations that you make it.
And we're gonna try to fly the Komodo FPV rig through this little gap there. So Nikolai is currently testing it with his 5-inch drone and just zipping by here, which is quite impressive. All right, so we just wrapped up shooting some additional shots on the ground to round up the whole project and give it more flavor and dimension. So let's check out our e-bike ad. What do you think about the shots? What do you think about that whole ad? I'm personally very impressed by what you can capture, even with a big CineLifter. It can get into very, very similar territory as what these 5-inch drones fly. You gotta definitely put a lot of time in if you want to get to that level of Nikolai. I've seen his journey from the beginning when he got the DJI FPV and was already like after a day diving down buildings, which was very impressive. Just goes to show that if you're a 20 something year old, you grew up with your mobile phone in your hand, you possibly have a little bit more connection to these kind of technology pieces, and also I guess your sense of risk is lower. You know, us in the 30s, we just like always like concerned that something happens. Look at the chalk in the tires here.
Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. We certainly enjoyed making it and shooting the shit over the weekend and coming up with a random project to try out some new gear. But if you did, definitely leave a thumbs up. Also, I will leave links to the gear below. If you're in market for a new e-bike and you want to check them out, I will leave a link to 10 ways down below as well. And as always, have a good morning, have a good night, wherever and whenever you are around this very beautiful planet. Bye bye. Thank you.